Hi there, it's me, Adil Ahmed. In previous lecture, we created this. Just see. We have created this Facebook header in previous lecture, like logo, search bar, search icon, then we have profile picture, name, and menus. Okay. In this lecture, we will design as similar as Facebook. Just I am going to Facebook to show you what we are going to do in this entire lecture. Now it is loading. After loading, we will discuss. You can see here we have profile picture, here we have menu, then we have friend request icons, then messages icons, then notifications. After this, we have privacy shortcuts, then drop down, right? So we will design here. We will put home button, then all those things. So let's do. Here we have Facebook header. Just I am going to editor like notepad. Here we have notepad. I am opening it, okay, and just finding here where is my profile picture, okay. So you can see this is a profile picture. We have discussed about this in a later lecture. In a previous lecture we have discussed already, right? So I am coming just down to this li closing tag and mentioning here li, another li, okay, and closing as well. So whenever you start any tag, you must have to close that tag. If you don't close that tag, then that tag will not be applied, okay. So make sure when you start coding, then if you type any tag, then make sure to close that tag, right? Inside this li I am mentioning anchor tag. Anchor tag is basically used for putting the link just behind the text and the image, right? I am putting a home and saving it and going to the browser to show you. Okay, now refreshing, you can see here we have home button. It is as similar as this one, but here we have also a counter like 7. We have to put this counter same as here, okay, just next to the home button. So I am going to text editor. Here we have notepad plus plus and here we have li. So we have to put here a span tag. So I am putting a span tag here, right? A span tag is basically used for inlining code, right? I am putting here span, then class. I am using here predefined classes of Bootstrap that is called bads. Okay, this will show the counter there. I am closing this span tag as well. And now I am putting the numbers. Suppose I have 9 updates on my home page, so I am putting 9 here. Control S, but it will update automatic when we will apply the PHP, okay. Only I am designing here the front end. After this we will design the back end. So whenever anyone makes the post on your home page, then you will get the perfect notification, right? I am saving it and going to the browser. Just refresh it. You can see here we have nice notifications, badge icon, okay. So now it is looking just like this one, but not perfect this. So we will design this in the later lecture. You can see here we have icons like friend requests, messages, notifications, then settings, after this drop down. So we will have to find the icons to enable these icons to our project, right? We have to attach these three icons just right here, okay. So let's do that. I'm going to Bootstrap official website just by taking another new tab and mentioning here Bootstrap. After mentioning this, just hit the enter button. You can see here we have link Bootstrap, the world's most popular mobile first and responsive front end. We have to follow this link, click on it. Here we have getting started and components. If you want to go through this one, you can also go, or if you want to this, click on it. Components. Whenever you click on the components menu, then you will get the glyph icons on the first page. If you don't find this, then simply at the right side you can see glyph icons, drop downs, button groups. Click on drop downs, click on glyph icons, then you will get this one, right? Just I am scrolling this page to find my icons. You can see here we have users icon, like users. So we have to put here users. If you want to find your icon, simply press Ctrl F and mention here user. You can see here we have user icon, okay. So we will use this icon on the place of this username, friend request. Okay, then we have here messages. So for messages we will use icon like comments. The spelling should be correct. Just I'm going to top where is glyph icons. Here we have glyph icons and here we have messages. Okay, glyph icon envelope. We will use this icon on the place of these messages, or you can also add comments icon, right? If you want to add comments icon, then you need to find here where was the icon of comments. Just I'm scrolling this page to find the icon like comments. Okay, so it will take time to find the icon. Okay, if you know the code, then you will directly call that. If you don't know, then you need to find. You can see here we have glyph comment icon. We will use comment icon, or simply we will use the message icon just on the place of this icon messages. Okay, thereafter we have notifications. You can see here this icon is just like a globe icon, so we will put globe icon on the place of notification. You can see here your globe icons. Just I am going to top and searching here just by pressing Ctrl F and searching here globe. You can see this is as similar as this one, right? So we will use this globe icon on the place of this one. So I'm going back to the project. Here we need to put the icons like friend requests, comments, messages, notifications, setting and drop down. And we need to find also settings. So I'm going to components and mention here setting is not here actually, so I am putting a cog, COG. You can see it is as similar as settings, but you can see here we have different types of settings like lock. So we will use lock icon on the place of settings. So I am using here lock, LOCK. You can see here we have lock icon. So we will use this icon on the place of this one, right? Then we have drop down. It's actually a caret. It is called caret. Okay, so whenever we have to use this icon, then we will use there just caret. When you use caret, then you will get this icon. Okay, so I will guide you all the things to go through, right? So in this lecture, what we create this one home menu, then notifications. I hope you enjoyed it. Okay friends, so friends, it's done now. See you in the next lecture. Till then, have fun and goodbye friends. In next lecture we will discuss this one, the color attaching or logo making and this icon enabling. Okay, so I hope you enjoyed. Friends, don't forget to subscribe my channel to get more and more free updates from this channel. Okay, bye.